One, two, three.
Yay!
Go on, louder. One, two, three.
Yay!
Yeah.
getting tired of being ballsy, isn't it?
How did the match went today then, lads? Are you glad for the result?
Yeah. Amazing result, amazing result.
Who did you want to win before you
start? We're proud of the mosque.
We're proud of the
priest. We went to the mosque to win.
We're very proud of the imam. But overall,
we're proud of both teams. You know, we accepted him childish football, but we didn't get that. We got some really good professional footballers out there.
Delighted with that win!
It's often the kids, you know, who are ahead of us on what's going to happen in a town like this down the line, how it's going to actually work. And they showed the way today.
We've been the tournament organisers along with Farook
Yunus.
We've been there. We came in, he approached us saying that, you know, the kids have an idea, let's get a tournament. So we thought, yeah, we'd like to get the experience. It's the first time we've done anything like this. So we thought we'd try and make a good event. So the main thing behind it is bringing the communities together. After everything that we've seen in the press, you know, we want to put a better image between everyone that, you know, oh, this is what we want to accomplish. We want a good community cohesion, especially around this area.
Well, you see, the whole process, we use youngsters aged 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 years old and get them involved in this process. Hopefully, they will grow up as ambassadors. They will grow up and they will take the flag in their hands and they will talk to people with a different understanding.
I thought the match was brilliant because the mosque, they won. Not just that, but the churches also played very well. And I thought one of the teenagers of the churches was very well played.
Today was about just having fun together. And, you know, you can sit around the table and you can chat and you can try and work things out. But there's nothing like actually doing something together. And we did something together. This whole day has got us together to sort of plan it, to plot it, to make phone calls, to make emails. And we were united just in that process. Even if it had poured with rain, today would have been a success. As it was, the Lord blessed it with beautiful weather and a beautiful atmosphere of love.
We started in February, as the planning wise, and to be honest, it's been well worth it, I can tell you that. We had other commitments as well, so Muhammad's working, I'm at university, and so we had to kind of integrate that into our other commitments as well.
It's been an exciting project, brilliant. We love being part of it.
It was interesting that whichever team was playing uphill with the wind against them seemed to be doing better, which is bizarre.
Divine help.
So the divine help, there we go. Yeah.
It is responsibility of ours, please, to take this, my friends, my brothers, my sisters, and let's work together. We cannot do this as one individual. We need everybody, Muslims, Christians, Jews, any religion, to come together as human beings. As human beings. And if there is a need, if there is a problem in society, we should all link and tackle those problems together.
You know, I think all over the country, there are Muslim and Christian neighbours who get on really well. You know, they know their next door neighbours well, they love each other, they do all kinds of stuff for each other. And maybe what there's not been enough of is at a more structural level as doing stuff together. You know, I know Abid, the imam at our local mosque, and we got on brilliantly. And, you know, we've been into each other's places of worship and spoken to each other's people. And maybe we just don't do it publicly enough. And maybe, you know, something like this starts to rectify that balance a bit.
Our role today is we help promote this as much as we can through a press release. We help provide the footballs, the equipment, and we also arrange for the CEO of West Riding County FA to come down and attend and support this event.
Very good thing that speaks through Christianity and Islam that we need to look after our neighbours. And our hope is that events like today and other things that we do here in Kirklees through the Faiths Forum are all about building up neighbourliness and making us better a place where people can look at Dewsbury and not think bad things of it, but to think that this is a place where people actually live and work together and change that bad reputation.
Look around and just everyone's mixing in. It's from different ethnic backgrounds. Yeah. Everyone's just mixing in. It's really nice to see. We should do that more often.
Do you think that the Christians will be at cricket?
No!
I think it'll build a lot better relations with the community in light of what's been going on in the media the last couple of months or so. In light of the Sikhs from Birmingham that being obviously charged and obviously being sentenced as well. I think in terms of cohesion, having the mosques and the churches and different faiths coming together for this such a fantastic event and such a lovely day as well. It brings communities together, and that is what it's actually about. Bringing young, old, and all people from all walks of life together.
I've lived in this town for 2 years, and you could make a soup with all the perceptions that are in it. I hear stuff on both sides, to be honest. And that's why Farook and I, who just like each other, we don't agree with everything, but we like each other. We can't help but like each other. We make each other laugh. So we just decided to do this. We didn't really have an agenda other than the fact that let's have a game of football.
It's obviously a great thing that's happened today, but in one sense, it's no big deal. This is happening all over the country with Christians and Muslims, people of different religions, playing and having fun together. So I'm delighted to be involved, but in one sense, it's no big deal. It's having a good kickabout. And I'm disappointed with the result. I think we should have won. Well, perhaps not. I think we did all right.
They had the second half.
They had the speed second half.
The Prophet, peace be upon him, said that none of you can be a true believer until he loves for his brother and sister what he loves for himself. According to many of the Islamic scholars, here brotherhood means brotherhood in humanity. That you cannot be a true believer until you want for all of humanity what you want for yourself.
I think the game was amazing, played in a good spirit. Even sides, although the Muslim side had the edge in the end. Yeah. But I think it'll build relationships, build bridges, build community. Yeah. I've made some good friends today.
Just saw tons of kids running about, and that's what it's all about. I think what Farook said is quite right. It doesn't just happen overnight. It takes tons of volunteers to make today happen. And all the people that you've seen in the highs, these jackets, there was tons of them. They're coming out from everywhere. I just think they should be given the biggest round of applause for today. They've done a fantastic job, but the volunteers have been great.
We're raising money for Dewsbury Hospital. Dewsbury hope by the end of next week, Friday, we've already raised about £1,000. Our target is £5,000 to be raised by Friday next week. We'll do it.
The very memory was seeing so many people turn up to such a lovely event. All being together, enjoying themselves, having a good fun day out. And it's not about win or lose, it's about coming together and bonding together.
It went absolutely fantastic. It's kind of part of the ethos of Sporting Equals, to bring communities together with the power of sport, and that's what we want to do. We want to push it, and hopefully after this event we don't want it to stop here. We want to build from this, develop other projects, and hopefully empower this community to move on and do better things.
If we don't get to know each other, the misunderstandings will stay, and those misunderstandings, they'll increase, and if they increase, it will develop into more problems, and sadly what we see around the world is that goes on to violence and then death eventually.
My abiding memories of today are friendship, togetherness and harmony.
I think today will stay in people's memories. It's not like we haven't got any more problems now, but this is going to stay in people's memories. So next time the emotions rise, they might remember today and the emotions might come back down again, and that will be a triumph.